Hello friends and welcome again. In this PowerPoint animation tutorial, we are going to animate this Pac-Man ghost character, and it is inspired by Oi's work at dribble.com. You can download this presentation and the link has been given in the video description. We will first talk about the character and scene design for which we used the shape tools. When you open a presentation in PowerPoint and want to know how it has been designed, then the best way is to select all the objects either by pressing the Ctrl+A key, or you can also click Select All from the Select drop-down menu with the Home tab. After selecting all the objects, choose No Fill from the Shape Format tab, and apply an outline color. Then most probably, you will start seeing the actual design of the presentation. You should also take the help of Selection Pane, which you can again open from the Select drop-down menu, and should note down the placement of all the layers. The Selection Pane shows all the objects according to their position over the slide. Like, the first object in the list is on top and the last object is behind all the other objects on the slide. The positioning of objects can help you to hide objects behind each other, so the viewer may only see those layers that you want to show him during the slideshow. The other important thing is using the right colors. Like, if we change the background color of the slide, then you still only see a part of the background and the rest of the part is still of blue color. That is because we are hiding a lot of layers behind these blue rectangles that we have placed on top. If we hide these rectangles through the selection pane, then you will start seeing the actual Pac-Man ghost character design, and white and black waves placed on top of it. Let's turn on all the layers and change the slide background color to blue again. You might now have the idea that how positioning layers and fill color can help you to hide things behind each other. That is the only way to see the desired layers during the slideshow, as there is no masking option available in PowerPoint. Now let's see which animation effects we are using in this presentation. A total of 9 effects has been applied. Motion path has been applied over 7 layers and grow shrink effect on 2 layers. If we expand the animation pane to its maximum size and scroll the timeline, then you can see that it is endless because we are repeating all the 9 animation effects until the end of the slide. If we also note down the time duration of these effects, then you will see that only the first 2 layers have a time duration of 3 seconds and the rest 7 layers are of only 1.50 seconds, but still the black lines of the effects loop are of equal sizes. Like, if I change the duration of any of these effects, then you can see that black lines between loops also change their position according to time duration and delay timings. You also see the number of boxes divided by black lines according to the number of times the effect will run. Let's say, if we change the first effect from until the end of the slide to 3 times, then you will only see 3 boxes. So how does the animation pane is showing the equal size of all the effect boxes, even the time duration is different? That is because the first 2 effects are of 3 seconds, and if you open the effect options window, then you can notice that we are not using the auto reverse option. Whereas the other 7 effects are of 1.5 seconds, but we are using auto reverse. So, the one complete loop of these effects will be equal to 3 seconds, and that is why all the black lines in the animation pane are of equal size. Now, let's talk about the motion path effect that we applied over the black and white waves. If we zoom out and see the size of these wave shapes, then it is very small, but when you run the slideshow, then both waves run endlessly to the left. It totally depends on the object size and the motion path effect length. If I change the motion path length of any of the waves, then you will start seeing glitches between the loops. Like, if we see the black and white wave without the blue rectangles during the slideshow, then you will have the idea that how they are making a loop. Also, we have placed the white wave on top of one blue rectangle. So, when the white color wave moves over the blue rectangle, then it creates a nice effect and the black wave is running in reverse direction in the background. so, to make an exact endless loop even over the small length layers, the motion path start and positions should match with the object size. Even both the wave size is smaller than the slide size, but still both runs in a loop without glitches because the blue rectangles are on top of them. Otherwise, we need to draw a bit wider waves than the slide size. We used the left and right motion path on wave layers, and down motion path for the face and eyes. On face and eyes, we have also applied the auto reverse as we want them to move up and down in a loop. For crown on top and shadow at the bottom, we are using the grow shrink effect. The crown is growing at 150% vertically and the shadow is growing at 150% horizontally. It will be also a good idea to see the slideshow with all the objects only having the outline color but not the fill color. That way, you may clearly see how and which objects are moving, and which are static objects. I hope you might have learned something new and informative. Do let us know by liking, sharing, and commenting. Subscribe to our channel as there are a lot more tutorials to come. Thanks a lot for watching. Bye and have a nice weekend.